Greetings to you all. Welcome to this EPI webinar introducing you to the CDF OS through the sneak peek. My name is Edward van Leent. I'm the chairman and CEO for the EPI group of companies, and today joining me is the CTO for EPI, Jan-Willem Moren. What we would like to do today is discuss a few things. First, we will give you a quick overview about who is EPI, just for those of you who might not be familiar with us yet. Then we have the EPI data center training. We'll give you a slight overview of what we have for you. And then we dive into the main topic of today, the CDFOS sneak peek, which will be presented by Jan-Willem. And then, of course, we open the floor for you for any questions that you might have, which you can post on the chat window in the question section. So without further ado, quick introduction to EPI. We are originally from the UK, started in 1987. So we are well in the 33-year-old company that we have. In 1999, we set up an office in Singapore, and that is now our global headquarters. We have 11 offices around the world, basically serving every continent on this very planet. And we work through either direct operations or through our valued partners, which we have in over 60 countries, serving over 130 cities. EPI is a data center expert company. This is the business that we have been in ever since we started. And we are providing three distinct services. One is what we call the design evaluation and validation. This is a service that is aimed at those who will embark on a data center design and build project, or who are going through some renovation and alteration of their existing facility. This service will have us going through all your design documents and making sure that they are conform the chosen standard. One of the most popular standards that we are auditing for is the TIA 942, but we also doing services around EN 5600 and the ISO 22237. We also do the physical data center audit and certification, so the facility certification, again, typically based on the NCTIA 942, as well as on the EN and the ISO standard, but we are also conducting audits at the governance, maintenance, and operational level for data centers based on the DCOS, the Data Center Operations Standard. And then we are also in the area helping the market getting better knowledge and understanding of data centers through our professional training programs. So having a look at the data center training, because we do IT training as well, but for the intent and purpose of this webinar, a quick overview of the portfolio that we have for data center training. Without going through too much detail, I just give you some highlight. DCFC at the bottom is the foundation course for those who want to enter into the data center market and do have little or no experience. And then we have three tracks. On the left, you will see the design and build track. As it says, this is aimed at those who are in the design and build part of the data center professional industry, helping people to understand how to design and build data centers. So we are going to talk about standards, methodologies, as well as technology, all from a vendor neutral perspective. On the right hand side, you will see the standards and compliance track. This is aimed for those who want to build a data center based on the TIA 942 specifications, where we have the consultant course to highlight all the requirements of the standard, as well as the auditor's course for those who would like to review their data center facilities themselves. And in the center, you will see the governance and operations track. In that one, we have four courses. On the right-hand side, you see the risk management course. Understanding the risks of your data center is, of course, at the basis of doing any design and build project, because you need to understand the risks you are potentially exposed to and that you would like to avoid or mitigate, as well as the migration specialist course. And on the left, you will see the two operation courses, the CDFOS course, the Certified Data Center Facility Operations Specialist course. That is the one that you will get to see a preview of, and as well as the Operations Managers course, the CDFOM. So that was my short introduction. So I'm going to hand over the honors now to Jan Willem-Moren, our CTO, to give you a sneak peek into our newly released CDFOS, the Certified Data Center Facilities Operations Specialist course. Jan, take it away.
Thank you, Edward. Welcome, everyone. My name is Jan. And indeed, I will continue from here with the CDFOS sneak preview in a somewhat roller coaster approach. The CDFOS course is covering all aspects on data center operations. The topics in this course are aligned with the DCOS, the Data Center Operations Standard, which is perhaps a topic that we will talk about for another time. For now, let's focus on the course, and we have a course agenda. 9 topics covered in 3 days, and let's have a look at the topics in a little bit more detail. The first module we are touching upon is service level management. So to make sure that we are able to inform the customer and user with the services that we have available from the get-go. As a data center service provider, you wish to understand what your customer requirements are, and once known, these services are to be implemented, operated, and supported. For the customer to understand what services are available, we have created a service catalog, which is based on the needs analysis and capability assessment. And once we have interested customers, we will sign them up as part of the contract. There is then most probably a service level agreement in place. Service level management is a very dynamic process. Organizations seldomly stay the same for a long period of time, and hence service demands change, often resulting in service improvements or total replacements. And therefore, the service level management process is ideally making use of the well-known PDCA cycle. It is possible for multiple SLAs to exist, and if such is the case, it is of course the challenge for the data center service provider to manage infrastructure and organizational capabilities, keeping customers satisfied at all times. For sure, an important aspect of data center operations is safety related. Not only do we want to make sure that safety is being practiced for the well-being of our operations staff, we also need to make sure that as an organization, we remain compliant to law and regulations, since after all, safety is mandated by law. Organizations who are serious about safety commonly make use of a so-called organizational health and safety manual, covering all aspects of safety during operations. And this, of course, includes possible emergencies that may occur at any time of the day. So an organization does good in creating an emergency response plan, whereby you try to address all thinkable emergencies, so that as an organization, you are prepared once such emergency occurs. And indeed, surprise, surprise, one of those emergencies is what we are facing as we speak, such as a pandemic. Looking at information security, a topic which sits reasonably high on the priority list of many organizations. And when you operate a data center, the focus, however, is not so much on the technical side of it, but more on the physical aspects. And that is exactly what we will cover in this particular course. For physical security to be effective, lots of standard operating procedures that apply, addressing security zones, entry and access control, security patrol, and so on. Security is commonly a separate unit or department within a data center organization, and quite often outsourced as well. Regardless of that, security monitoring needs to take place ideally around the clock, and this is normally taken care of by the security staff operating in the security operations command center. Do take notice, where outsourcing does take place, it is of course highly recommended to have a service level agreement in place with the external service provider. A data center, being a type of facility, is making use of a large number of equipment to be found mainly in the mechanical and electrical infrastructure. And of course, it doesn't stop there. Apart from the actual maintenance on equipment and facility, we need to make sure that we organize all supporting activities, which we can see on this particular slide. One thing that we know about equipment is that if we don't take care, it will fail sooner or later. And in order to prevent this, a facilities maintenance management system must be in place to look after the equipment, ultimately protecting investment and the business. One of the keywords is obviously availability. When equipment breaks down, it may seriously affect an organization's ability to operate. A silent and mostly not visible enemy of a data center and its availability is contamination. Hence, as part of the facilities maintenance module, we are addressing these concerns, the causes for contamination, and of course also how to respond to it to prevent it from happening in the first place. The largest module of the course is covering data center operations. In this module, we will discuss all relevant topics of the typical day-to-day activities, including service management, capacity management, floor management, and equipment lifecycle management. The service desk is the first point of contact for customers and end users, and therefore an important aspect of a data center organization. The service desk is responsible for all service management related aspects. This, of course, depending on the disciplines that have been adopted by the data center service provider. Incidents are a disturbance of a service, and this is commonly the most visible service management process for customers and end users. And for the service desk organization, at the same time, it doesn't stop here, since incidents may turn into problems, and these problems may require a change. So to solve a root cause issue in the data center infrastructure, or perhaps in the organization responsible. All these disciplines, of course, will be touched upon in the CDFOS course. Staging or testing of the ICT equipment is a very important aspect of data center operations. To make sure that the equipment soon to be installed in the computer room is fit for operational purpose. Students of the CDFOS course therefore will get exposed to the details of staging. Capacity in a data center is not infinite. Working in data center operations also includes managing capacity of typically four areas, being power and cooling infrastructure, the telecom, or mostly referred to as network infrastructure, and the physical space throughout the data center. Floor management is covering a huge chunk of data center operations, since it involves all activities related to the computer room. Larger data center service providers have dedicated teams of staff focusing on floor management, which includes all processes involving equipment installation, and therefore it's not only the installation itself, but also the pre-installation activities, the post-installation activities, and when the equipment is reaching its functional or economical end of life, decommissioning and or replacement activities will take place as well. Monitoring and reporting ideally take place around the clock so that whenever there are reasons for concern, the team responsible can timely identify these concerns and respond to it such that ideally incidents can be prevented from happening. Where prevention is not possible, the incident simply is occurring, immediate response to the incident needs to take place so that we can try to look after making data center services available anytime soon. Monitoring activities are also required to satisfy customers in line to what has been agreed upon in SLAs, and this is in many cases a contractual requirement. The bottom line of monitoring is to make sure that it is aligned with the business requirements of the data center and, of course, its customers and or end users. Reporting, therefore, needs to take place on a regular basis so that we have an idea of the current state of the data center. Reporting serves both the internal organization and external customers and users. And depending on how the reporting functionality is implemented, nowadays it is virtually possible to report on any aspect of the data center, be it real-time or scheduled-based. At the minimal, reporting takes place as per the contractual agreements, and usually this includes equipment failures, business outages, and compliance against SLAs, and so on. In a dynamic environment such as the data center, changes are always ongoing, and some of the changes are of such nature that it needs to be organized in a project. Hence, the CDFOS student learns about project management related aspects in order to organize and execute projects successfully. Projects are very different from day-to-day operations using specific processes and disciplines, and therefore it is important for an organization to make sure that all participants are on the same plane of communication. The project manager is literally the spider in the web, pulling all the strings to make sure that the project is going forward. Therefore, the project manager is ideally formally trained in the discipline of project management, since the responsibilities of bringing a project to a successful end are normally quite high, knowing that there is a lot at stake. Environmental sustainability. It can be argued that data centers are not environmental friendly, and although there is truth in that, at the same time, we can make sure that we make an effort to operate our data center as environmental friendly as we can. There are plenty of reasons why sustainability is important, and I always live by the principle to say, as a company, if you don't do it for the reasons of protecting the environment, do it at least for the possible savings, allowing you to operate your data center more cost efficient. There are a lot of initiatives data center can take in order to meet their sustainability objectives, which we will discuss in the CDFOS course. And one of these activities, and sometimes easily overlooked, by the way, is water management. So for those of you who plan to attend the course, brace yourself for a very good lesson on how to go about. Last but not least, governance and compliance activities do take place in operations as well. Although commonly a management topic, there are some activities for which the data center operations staff are responsible, and these activities are discussed in this particular module. Personally, I cannot stress out how important documentation is, and yet we know that many data centers struggle with keeping up their documentation, and this is mainly caused by one or two issues, being a management issue and or a disciplinary issue. In practice, when you are not being able to make use of documentation when you need it the most, it will very likely introduce data center on availability. Therefore, in the CDFOS course, we will discuss the documentation life cycle. Another aspect is asset management, which is a discipline closely related to the service management aspects that we are also discussing in the module data center operations. The bottom line of asset management is that if you do not know your assets, you are practically flying blind in data center operations. With that, we conclude the course, and then of course it is time for our students to get ready for the exam. It is a closed book exercise, 60 questions in total, which are multiple choice based, and as a student you have 90 minutes to complete the test. Those who score 42 or above will receive the CDFOS certificate, which is globally recognized as we can see on this particular slide. EPI courses are accredited by EXIN and certificates are much sought after, boosting the careers of data center professionals. With that, I have come to the end of the sneak peek, but it is not yet the end of our session. The floor is now open for a Q&A session, question and answers. So if you have a question, this is the moment for you to ask. So the floor is open for you to ask your questions. Any questions from the floor? All right, there's a few questions coming in. Okay, I see one question that says, what is covered in the Data Center Foundation course? Is it similar to the CDCP? Well, there are some differences. I guess for you to best understand is to download both brochures from the epi-ap.com website and do a quick comparison. If my team has taken CDFOM in the past 2 years, what would they learn from CDFOS that they have not been taught under the past CDFOM classes? CDFOS is covering operational aspects that we also see in CDFOM. In terms of how much material you learn new, I think it's a bit challenging to answer that question correctly. But there is indeed some level of overlap in the previous CDFOM and the new CDFOS course. Pricing for 2 or 3 day session, request for classroom, self-paced and online instructor enabled courses with optimal price would help, as there are a lot of companies cut short salary benefits and so on and so on. In terms of commercial related aspects, I suggest that you are getting in touch with the EPI accredited training provider companies. They will be able to answer all your questions which are of a commercial basis. Are there exam sample questions? Yes, we worked very hard on sample questions. These can be found in the back of the student manual, and they are ready as we speak. Is there any special or different type of DC management for T1, T2, T3, or T4? I may assume that it is referred to as tier levels, also known as rating or rated levels as per the TIA 942. I would suggest that... let me read the question again. Is there any special or different type of DC management? Oh, okay, all right. So, well, obviously, the more equipment, for example, that you have in the data center, the more maintenance you need to require. But of course, there is a bit of a baseline approach that you would follow for all type of data centers. regardless your tier rating level and or regardless whether you are a commercial data center or enterprise. Is there an expiry date for certification? Yes, there is. After 3 years, the certificate expires, after which you ideally renew so that you keep your certificate in good standing order. There are several ways to renew. Information can be found on the EPI website and also in all our course manuals. Another question. I believe the course is online. Could you explain more on commercial and exam? Is there any prerequisite to take up this course? There is no prerequisite in the sense that it would be nice if the candidate is working in the data center, in data center operations. That should be a good fit for attending this particular course. Again, commercially, I wish to refer to the accredited training providers for more information. The course is online in a way that you can currently download the brochure. Hello, another question. As a project manager and a facilities in charge, which course should I take, CDCP or CDFOS? Good question. Perhaps both. CDFOS is purely focusing on operations. So if you are not deeply involved in operations, it is a bit hard to tell whether or not you should follow the CDFOS course. If you design data centers as a project manager, then CDCP is a very welcoming course. If you are also heavily involved in designing and handing over to operations, then I would suggest that you take notice of what are the aspects of operations, and then the CDFOS course can be very helpful for you. When is the CDFOS, CDFOM available in TOD? TOD short as short for training on demand. Am I saying that correct, Edward? TOD, help me out here. Yeah, training on demand. We are working on it as we speak. I can't give you a fixed date, but definitely in the next coming months, we hope to have both the courses online for TOD. I saw a promotion on the CDFOS training with a free DCOS. Can you explain what is the DCOS and how would it benefit me as the student? DCOS is short for Data Center Operation Standards and is providing a guidance for data center operations team to further optimize their operations. So there are 11 disciplines in total, and 9 of these disciplines are covered in CDFOS. Why are there 2 missing? The reason is those 2 missing items, which is operational resilience and data center organizations. These are the topics discussed in the CDFOM level, the manager level, and are not specifically for operators. So 11 disciplines in the data center operating standard, which can be used to further optimize your data center operations. And it is also a certifiable standard. More information on DCOS can be found at epi-ap.com/DCOS. Does EPI provide any job assistance after completion of this course? Well, that's a good question. Default, but of course, you can always shoot me an email to say, would you know of any openings that maybe I can apply for? But that is, I think, as far as it goes. Do you plan to have customized courses for professionals who are both project managers and facilities in charge? Customized. Well, we can customize. But if such request is present, I suggest that you contact EPI directly and we need to talk further details. Could you provide the contact to discuss further? We are based in Doha, Qatar. Edward, can you help me out? Doha, Qatar, who to contact?
Yeah, that would be best to contact Roshan. So I believe that we get all the questions as well later on, so we can contact you and give you the specific. But it's we have a local person there overseeing the Middle East region.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, I can see, by the way, at the time that we are slowly running towards the end, so I try to speed up a little bit. Can I take the course without certification? Conversely, can I take the exam only without following the course? Yeah, that's a common question we get a lot. You need to follow the course and then you do the exam. So it's basically a package that you purchase, and it cannot be done one or the other or the other way around. Is the CDFOM course covering all the aspects contained in CDFOS? Well, the topic names are in many cases the same. There is sometimes a bit overlap in terms of content, but we will present it from a management point of view or from an operator point of view. So having that said, I think both courses are still fairly unique. One specifically for the operator, the other one specifically for the manager. We are currently having our own operations processes. What is the impact if we send our staff for this training, and what do they learn that we may not be doing at this very moment? Again, CDFOS and CDFOM are aligned to the data center operations standard, and this standard has been created with input from experts all over the world, and therefore it is a very good representation of how typically data centers operate all around the world. So therefore you get a very good feedback from the industry, so to speak, while attending these courses, so that you learn how the big players in the industry are doing it when it comes to data center operations. I am data center operations. I certify CDFOM before must be taken CDFOS. No, again, CDFOM will continue to exist, but will from very soon onwards focus on managing aspects only. If you really need to learn about operations only, then CDFOS is the most suitable course. Can you do a private class for my team? That is always possible. Please contact us and we can talk further. I completed CDCP. Can I proceed CDFOS? I am working in DC operations. You are more than welcome. CDFOS and CDFOM, is it the same certification? No, it is not. They are different. Again, one is operations, the other one is for managers. I did CDCP in 2013. Now I want to do CDCS and CDFOM. What shall I do? Do I need to do CDCP again? Well, if you did your CDCP in 2013, your certificate expired in 2016. So in order to go to CDCS, you first need to recertify your CDCP. However, you are more than welcome to sign up for our CDFOM course. All right, that was a large number of questions. Thank you so much. Anything else from the floor? All right. If you do have any more questions after this session, feel free to contact us. Do not hesitate. It's very common that after presentations, people go like, oh yeah, I forgot. You can contact us. You can see the email address on the slide, sales@epi-ap.com. And we are more than happy to answer your questions. We have a few more minutes left. So anything that is on your sleeve right now, feel free to share with us. Okay, I think then we are slowly going to end the session. I will keep the very last word to Edward, our CEO, but at least on my behalf, I would like to thank you for making your valuable time available for attending this session. It has been my pleasure, And I hope to see you forward in our courses in the future. Back to Edward for the final words.
Thanks, Jan, for the perfect explanation. Thank you for the audience to attend. And again, thank you for all those who had excellent questions. What we will do, we'll download the question sessions as well, and we'll follow up for you. There was a question about the live recording as well. The session is recorded, and you will receive a link where you can review it again if you wish to do so. Again, if you have any questions, you know how to find us at the sales@epi-ap.com. Please do reach out if you want to have more information, if you have any other question left, and we hope to welcome you in one of our sessions soon. Again, thank you very much for your attention, and we're looking forward to speaking to you soon. Take care all, and be safe.